Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to start with the new poem of your English textbook, Honeycomb. The name of the poem is Garden Snake. So this poem is written by Muriel L. Soni. And before starting the poem, let me ask you a question. Have you ever seen a snake fighting with a mongoose or getting into a hole or swimming in the river? Everyone of us, you know, almost everyone believes that snakes are very dangerous and poisonous. But some snakes are not at all dangerous. Most snakes, we would say, are not dangerous. So, this poem, Garden Snake, it's a very simplistic description of a harmless snake. And the young child here, narrator, encounters a snake in the garden and runs away from it out of fear. However, his mother informs him that certain kinds of snakes are not at all dangerous. They feed merely on insects. The young child narrator loses his fear thereafter and begins to watch the snake pass through the garden. So now this is about, this is the brief introduction of the poem. So let me read out the poem. All of you look at the poem. I saw a snake and ran away. Some snakes are dangerous, they say. But mother says that kind is good and eats up insects for his food. So when he wiggles in the grass, I'll stand aside and watch him pass and tell myself there is no mistake. It's just a harmless garden snake. So the poet here in the above lines describes how the child's fear gets replaced and he is able to watch the snake with delight. The young child here sees a snake and runs away thinking the snake to be dangerous. His mother, however, tells him that some particular kinds of snakes are not dangerous but good. They eat nothing but insects. And thereafter, the narrator no longer, when his mother, talks about the harmless, snakes, the narrator, no longer afraid, used to stand aside and sees the snake wiggle in the grass. So every time the narrator sees the garden snake, he reminds himself that there is nothing wrong as this is just a harmless garden snake. So it's a very small poem. I hope all of you must have understood what is the meaning of these lines. Okay, so here the narrator, the poet, talks about a harmless snake, some harmless snakes. Okay, they are not at all dangerous until and unless you disturb them. Okay, so now let us discuss the question answers of this poem. Okay. So, what is the first question? The first question is, pick out the line that suggests that the child is afraid of snakes. So, here, which line do you think that the child is afraid of, which suggests that the child is afraid of snakes? Here, the first line itself, I saw a snake and ran away. This line suggests that the child is afraid of snakes. Now, moving on to the next question. The next question is, which line shows a complete change of the child's attitude towards snakes? Now, you have to read out these lines. So, the line which shows that, the child is no longer scared of the snakes. So, which line do you think? The line, I'll stand aside and watch him pass. So, this line is the correct answer. Okay. So, now moving on to the next question. But mother says that kind is good. What is mother referring to? So, here the mother is referring to the garden snake. The mother says that garden snakes are a very kind snake. Okay. They don't disturb others or even humans. Okay. Now, next question. Moving on to the next question. Find the word that refers to the snake's movements in the grass. So, the word which describes the snake's movement, it is wiggle. Now, the next question is, there are four pairs of rhyming words in the poem. So, you have to find out the pair of, four pairs of rhyming words from the poem. You have to just, say out the say the words loudly. So the words are good and food, pass and grass, then away and say, then mistake and snake. Now let us see the next question. The next question is, a snake has no legs or feet, but it moves very fast. Can you guess how? So here, a snake has no legs or feet. It wiggles on the surface. Okay. So they have no legs or feet, but how they move? They move, but it moves very fast. So how they move very fast? They wiggles on the surface. Okay. They wiggle on the surface. It's their movement. Okay, now let's see the next question. The next question is, can you recall the word used for a cobra's long sharp teeth? Where did you come across this word first? So, a cobra's long teeth are called, fangs, okay? F-A-N-G-S, fangs. So, you can say, where did you come across this word first? You can say in that way that you came across this word, some National Geographic channel. So, you might have seen cobra, okay, cobra's long sharp teeth in National Geographic channel, okay. So these are the question answers of this poem. So all of you must write down the poem and along with the question answers in your classwork notebook. So that's all for today. Thank you.